Welcome students. Now we see the second concept of the second unit called exceptions and errors. Errors are exceptions. There are two types of errors in Python called syntax errors and logical errors, which are also called the exceptions. Errors are the problems in a program due to which the program will stop the execution. Exceptions are raised when some internal events occur which changes the normal flow of the program. An exception is an error raised when there is a predefined error committed by the user. Next, syntax errors. Syntax errors are also known as parsing errors. That means, while compiling or interpreting or translating the program, the interpreter will find whether there are some errors or mistakes in the program or not. Such errors are generated while parsing the program. That's why they are also known as parsing errors. When the proper syntax of the language is not followed, then syntax errors are thrown. Example, A equal to 8, B equal to 10, C equal to A comma B. Means here, what action to take while this operation is being performed is not clearly mentioned. So it will generate an error, what operation to perform here. So the output is Python input 8th line number 3, invalid syntax. What to perform with this? A plus B or A minus B or A into B, nothing is clearly mentioned. There is a space only given, so which leads to some error. So syntax error is invalid syntax. This parse repeats the offending line and displays the little arrow pointing at the earliest point in the line where the error is detected. In our C programming, we used to get only the line number and appropriate message. But here, we do definitely get the simple arrow pointing to the location where there is an error. This is not the error actually, I am explaining. Then, the error is caused by or at least detected at the token preceding the arrow. So this arrow, this is the general identification for the error location. So it will show the location where the error is. File name and line number are printed so we know where to look in case the input came from a script. So syntax error is invalid syntax. Here another example, amount is 10,000, amount is greater than 2,999. Then you are trying to print the message. What is the error here? Yes, the error is missing colon. So we get the message invalid syntax because there is no colon symbol attached with the if statement. It returns a syntax error message because after if statement a colon is missing. So we can fix this by writing the correct syntax. Next, exceptions. These are called the logical errors. Even if a statement or expression is syntactically correct, it may cause an error when an attempt is made to execute it. Errors detected during the execution are called exceptions. Yes, they are exceptions, we call them. Errors detected during execution. Python provides two very important features to handle any unexpected error in Python programs and to add debugging capabilities in them. Those are exception handling and assertions. Most exceptions are not handled by programs, however, and result in error messages as shown here. Examples, 10 into 1 by 0, trace back most recent call last. So std in line 1 in 0 division error. Integer division or modulo by 0 is not a valid execution. Similarly, 4 plus spam into 3. Here spam is not a defined variable. Then similarly, 2 enclosed in single quotes is a string and 2 is an integer value. Cannot concatenate a string with integer objects. So these are the typical common errors that we find. Exceptions come in different types and type is printed as part of the message. See, the exception types in the example are zero division error, this is predefined, name error and type error. There are three different types of errors we have found so far. Handling exceptions. It is possible to write programs that handle selected exceptions. We can handle error by try except finally method. This is exclusively available in Java, not in C. We write unsafe code in the try, fall back code in except and final code in else block. See this syntax: try, do our operations here, except exception 1. If there is exception 1, then execute this block. Except exception 2. If there is exception 2, then execute this block. Else, if there is no exception, then execute this block. Finally, the finally block is placed to put any code that must execute. Here are few important points about above mentioned syntax. A single try statement can have multiple except statements. This is useful when the try block contains statements that may throw different types of exceptions. We can also provide a generic except class which handles any exception. Then, after the exception class or clauses, include an else class. The code in the else block executes if the code in try block does not raise any exception. This we have seen in while statement itself. The finally block is a place to put any code that must execute. Handling exceptions. FH is equal to open test file in read mode. FH.write, this is my test file for exception handling. Then except IO error. So if there is an IO error, then we display this message: can't find file or read data. Else, written content in the file successfully. So this is one kind of try. If this statement couldn't be executed successfully because of IO error, this statement is generated and it comes out. So this is one kind of exception. Output: error can't find file or read data because test file is not yet created. Then example 2, while true, try, x is equal to enter a number, raw input we have received, value error, that was no valid number, try again, because raw input will receive a string value and the type of value is converted to integer type. If any value error occurs because of this, that is value is stored like something unwanted or unexpected, then it displays this message which asks the user for input until a valid integer has been entered, but allows the user to interrupt the program that the user has generated. Interruption is signaled by raising keyboard interrupt exception. Argument of an exception. An exception can have an argument which is a value that gives additional information about the problem. Syntax: try, you do your operations here, except exception type argument, you can print value of argument here. Example: def temp convert var, try return int var, except value error argument, print the argument does not contain numbers. If this argument is not having any values, emptily if I give, then we get this kind of message. See this, the argument does not contain numbers. Here xyz is passed as a string, so that string will be received here, but it is a value error, so the output is generated. Raising exception. The raise statement allows the programmer to force a specified exception to occur. When we want to code for limitation of certain conditions, then we can raise an exception. Example: name error, hi there, trace back most recent call last. Here name error is hi there. For example, try for unsafe code, amount is equal to 1999. If amount is less than 2999, raise the value error. The value error is defined. Please add money in your account. else you are eligible to purchase. If false, then raise the value error. So if this condition is false, then the raise error will generate. Accept value error as E, print E. See that? Please add money in your account. Thank you. This is the end of the exceptions. We see programming examples later.